Happy Tuesday. Hope you're ready for core today. I'll give you just a second. You will need a ball or a yoga block or a towel or a pillow. You do not, it's not absolute that you have to have it, but you will need something to engage those legs with. All right, if you're joining me right from Kayla's class, that's even better because you're warmed up, you've had a nice little workout in. We're gonna go ahead and roll on down to the mat. Place the feet underneath the knees, resting the head on the floor, hands beside the body. We're gonna go up into a bridge, and you're gonna pause at the top and lower down. So just take it here with some gentle bridges. If you're coming right from your desk and you have not moved, I would suggest you do a little more moving around. This is gonna be a small little warm-up, just preparing the back, the abs and the hips and glutes for a little bit of extra work today. Pull those abdominals in, lift up through the pelvis, and down, hey baby. On your next raise, I want you to hold it in your bridge position. Butt is off the floor, we're lifting and we're holding. Abs are fully engaged, our shoulder blades are in the mat. I need you to leave. Move, go lay down, mama. No, no, go lay down. Lower down slow, all the way to the floor. Bring those heels in together. Allow the back to arch, allow the knees to fall open. Pull those shoulder blades into the mat, raising that chest and letting that back arch slowly. Then you're gonna pull in the abdominals and flatten that back into the floor. When you do that, your knees will lift off the mat slightly. And then release, arching through that back. And then pull those abs in, flattening that back out one more time. Hold here, engaging intensely, pulling those abs in. Walk those knees together. We're going to curl our head up, engage those abdominals, and just little reaches here towards the shin. You can touch with that little finger. Pull those abs in, creating that nice tension from the pelvis all the way to the top of the diaphragm. Keep that neck nice and long. Keep your chin off of your chest. Now on our next raise, we're gonna hold at the top on that reach. Let's reach to that right knee or right side of that shin and left. Stay tight here, stay nice and engaged. Starting to heat up, right? Four, three, two, and lower it down. Skin those legs out nice and long. Arms come up above the head, let that back arch. Oh yes, grab your block, your pillow, your towel, or nothing. But it does definitely help engage those abdominals, helps us get a little more into those abs. You're gonna take your block, pillow, whatever you got, place it between the knees, pull those abdominals in, so when I do, notice my knees come in. Then I want you to drive the knees out, right at the hip level. Holding here, focusing on that nice tension in the back against the mat. Right here, you should start to feel that slowly build up for us. Now we're going to inch our feet forward an inch, pull it back. Make sure that you have a nice long 90 degree angle up the knee. Your feet are not higher than your knees, and just make that movement small. Think about pulling in and starting from here, right in your center, your super core. Right here, we are working through pelvic neutral just to kind of edge in a little bit of my Pilates. If you've been in my Pilates class, this should be nothing. Right here, you should know exactly what you're doing, what's expected, what you should be feeling. Right here, you've got an option to either hold or lower the big toes to the floor, lift up. Now you will have to allow a slight arch in the back, But you don't want to create too much momentum or rocking where you lose that pelvic control. So I'm barely touching my tiptoes down, using my abs to pull it right back up. Stay engaged. You do not have to take your toes to the floor. You can hover them right above. Do what your back feels like doing today. Come on, use your breath. You have two more. Last one. Now bring those knees in. Give it a nice little squeeze. If you want to rock a little bit, still holding on to your equipment, whatever that would be. We're going to take those knees out right at the hips. Abs pull in, so we're engaged firmly into the floor. You're going to extend the legs, squeezing that block, and then come back. We're not rocking the knees past the hips. All we're doing is extending those legs, pulling in through our abdominals. Should be quite intense, but it should not be intense on the back. So if it's bothering the back, my suggestion would be to not lower the legs as far, maybe about a 45 degree angle. Squeeze that equipment between your thighs, whatever it is. If you do not have equipment, squeeze your thighs together. So the end point, everything is squeezing. All right, you know where we're going, I hope. We're adding that head up. So fingertips behind the ears, lift up through that upper torso, drop the legs back to center. Minimize this movement to what feels best on your back. Do not overstrain the back for abdominal gain. You won't gain it, I can promise you. Squeezing everything towards that center as you bring the legs back. Squeezing the inner thighs here. And release. Bring those knees in. Take your equipment out for now. All right. Glue those heels together. Pull those abdominals back in. We've let them rest momentarily. Heels in, toes point. Lower, lift. Lower, and lift. If you notice, if you're tight in your hands or your hip flexors, your upper body's gonna wanna follow you. Limit that, get a nice stretch, maintain your arch. When you're ready, if you wanna try to drop it a little lower, do so. Exhale on the way down, inhale on the way up. All right, hold at the top. You're going to drop out to about 45 degrees. If you need to bend your knees, you can. If you're feeling this intensely in your hip flexors, back off the movement. You can always modify, come to the floor and do one leg at a time here. All right, we're going to take it down 45 degrees, curl your head up, circle the legs outward and back together. Out, together. Determine how low you go for how much you can control your body and your back. Now we're going to reverse this direction right here. Out, in. So it's down and out. Curl that torso up, guys. Let's go. Four, three, two, and one. Lower those feet down. Let's extend the leg. Let's give those flexors a break for us. Fingertips behind the head. Curl that torso up. Let's flex the feet. Protecting the back. It's curl. Little pause right there at the top. Feel free to let your back arch a little bit when we come down. Just not hyperfocus, so we don't create too much momentum, but you can let off the gas, arch, pull those abs in tight and engage. creating just a little more power there by allowing those the back to release and then engage, curling up. You got it. Keep those elbows out of sight. I don't want them curling here. When we do that, we tend to pull the chin and head into the chest instead of working and lifting through our abdominals. You should barely see those elbows with your peripheral vision. You can stay here, or you can lift the right leg, then lift the left as you curl up. Keeping the foot flexed, keeping everything engaged tightly. If it's too much on the back, don't raise the leg. Exhale on that lift, inhale down. Once you kind of get into that deep, heavy breathing, you'll feel those deep abdominals fire off. I'm not kidding. And people thought in Pilates, we just breathe like that for fun. Or to sound like we're really working, right? Four, three, two, last one. Set those feet down, extend those arms overhead. Take a little miniature stretch here. All right, feet together. Now I'm going to encourage that if you do not feel these, take your block or a dumbbell. I like taking a block, it helps me lock my lower body into place. We're going into a windshield wiper. Some may know what to do, some may feel these by not doing anything extra. I like adding a little extra. Pull those abs in. We're gonna move the lower body as a unit to the right. Pull those abs in back to center. Make sure you are firing off those abdominals and we're not doing this. This is hardly any work at all and you're putting your rib back at risk. Nice and slow, it's lift. If your back will allow it, your knees are out past your hips, then you bring it back to center. All right, the full jackknife or the full windshield wiper is straight legs, lift. Straight legs, lift. Notice that when I lower, I'm going down at an angle away from my hips. So it's not a 90 degree swing left and right. You choose what you like, what feels best for you, and where you can get the most abdominal engagement. That's what's important. Without disturbing that back. You got it. Pull those abs back to center. Make this work for you. We're not here just throwing side to side. This is robotic. Pull those legs back to center. Pulling through those abdominals. Oh. You should feel that intensely. If not, get with me. Get a coaching session in. We'll go over abdominal contraction, pelvic floor control. We'll get there. It's worth it to know when you're working your abdominals, there shouldn't be a question of what exercise you're using or what muscle group you're using, excuse me. We're almost there, I promise. You're like, is this teacher counting or is she going in by feeling? Two more. So we have one. Last one here. Pull those feet in. Bring that block out and release. All right, feet come to the floor. Last week we did these rainbow crunches. We're going to do them again. If you'd like to add a dumbbell, I meant to bring one into my picture. I didn't. You could hold your dumbbell here. But if you're a beginner, this is fairly new to you, that I just want you to focus on form. You're gonna go up, over to the left, back down. So we stay almost on those shoulder blade tips because it'll feel awful uncomfortable and awkward if you try to lay your head down and then do that rainbow arch. We are going to the left first, that's four. Stay up there, the higher, the better, or the more comfortable for sure. Rolling across the bottom tips of that scap, or both scaps, I should say. To the right, right here. Up, rainbow to the right. It's a very small little arch. It should feel like something really big is going on, but you're not doing a big movement. Guess what? Again on the left side, head to the left. And eight more to the right. Curl it up and lift. Last one. Oh my goodness. Extend those arms out. Extend those legs out. Stretch. Lengthen that body from room to side, from wall to wall, or from room to room, however you want to see this. Nice deep breath in, exhale out. Let's walk our feet wide. And then I want you to drop your knees to the right, drop them to the left, loosening up that back. Kind of let your back know we're through. Oh, I better not sing this. Facebook will probably block me. It's a licensed song. All right. Hold the knees. Stack them over to the right. Take a little back and glute stretch here. You all know the drill. Look over that left arm. Let's take two breaths. All right. Release. Go back to the left. And here we go. Roll it back to center. Roll on to all fours. So meet me in a tabletop position. We're going to roll that back up. Back down and through. Pull those ears out of the neck. And then right back into a cat pose. One more in the cow. Let's come on down to our stomachs for our last little stretch here. Stay on the forearms, or if you feel like your back will manage it well, squeeze through those glutes. Lift up into seal pose. Drop those shoulders away from the ears. All right, release. Now we work a little bit of hip flexors in core, so I want you to reach back, grab that right ankle, push that right pelvis and thigh into the floor while you pull it. Lift up through that chest with that left arm pressing into the floor. Release. Other side, here we go. Grab that left foot. Push that left leg into the floor. Lifting up through the chest. Release, hands come beside the chest. Push up and off. Sink into child's pose. And I went over, didn't I? Good grief. I'm stretching like I've got a 30-minute class. Thanks for joining me. Have a great Tuesday.